An important feature of the ERIC Application Programming Interface, or API, is that you can export and save your search results. This video assumes you already know how to do an API search. If you need a refresher, watch the How Do I Start Using the ERIC API video first in the Multimedia section of the ERIC website. When searching with the API, you can specify saving results in XML or JSON, or if you want to display in an Excel spreadsheet in CSV format. The API search allows you to export up to 2,000 records at one time. However, if you are performing an extensive literature review, you may need to save more than 2,000 records at one time. There are two ways this can be accomplished: manually and automated. This video will explain both methods. Run your search using the ERIC API's Try It Out function and save the first 2,000 records in .csv format for display in an Excel spreadsheet. Next, go back to the API and make two changes in the parameter fields. For the Start field, enter 2001, and in the Rows field, enter 2000. Now rerun your search. You will now retrieve records numbered 2001 up to number 4000. Download the results as before and save them to an Excel file. You can then merge this Excel file with the one you saved from the first search. This iteration of the search can be repeated for as many records as you need to save. Instead of using Try It Out on the ERIC API page, you can automatically retrieve all records found from an API search by creating and running a Jupyter Notebook. First, you must have Jupyter Notebook installed on your computer. If you need assistance, there are tutorials on the web that walk you through the process. Next, write to ericrequests@ed.gov and ask for the PDF of the Jupyter Notebook coding instructions using Python language that ERIC has developed for conducting searches in the API. By creating a Jupyter Notebook from these instructions, you incorporate all the coding from the Try It Out function, but also include the coding for retrieval of all records in the search results. You can now enter your search string in this notebook, and when executed, the included coding of getAllERICRecords calls the getEricRecords function as many times as needed to fetch all search records. The function is called looping and automates the process. For example, this is a search to retrieve all records with the source of grantee submission. For more information about ERIC and Jupyter Notebook, view the webinar, Introducing the ERIC API.